Hello viewers, I am Rakib. Welcome to chapter 6, which is filter effects. And in this chapter, first two lessons will be about blur effects. And in this one, I will discuss about motion blur and radial blur. So for this image, I will apply motion blur. And to apply that, first we will separate our subject and the background. And I already have made the selection of the subject, and you can make the selection by the quick selection tool or any other selection tools that I discussed earlier. And after that, we will press Ctrl J to duplicate this subject, and then we will again hold Ctrl and click this layer to make the selection, and we will press Ctrl Shift I to make the inverse selection, and again we will select the background and we'll press Ctrl J to duplicate the layer. So now we have the background in the layer 2 and a subject in layer 1. We will also check this one to fill the cut area. And first we will apply the motion blur to this background. Before we apply that, we will convert it to a smart object, because the smart object has some smart features that will allow us to apply filter effects in an editable format, and we will be able to make adjustments later if we convert it to a smart object. So first we will right click here and select convert to smart object. So after that we will go to filter, blur, motion blur. And you can see the angle is 0, and we will keep it 0 for this image because we will apply it left to right, and it's parallel to the horizontal edges. But if you ever want it to in a different direction or in different angle, then you can change the direction from here, or you can also put a value here. Now I'll change it to 0. And the distance is the amount that how much we want to apply this effect. So we will increase it. So I'm going to keep it like this, as the before and after. We will click OK. But we want to apply it a very small amount to our subject as well, to keep it more realistic. So we will again convert it to a smart object. And we can copy this. Let's increase the size of this palette, and we can copy this exact same effect to this smart object. To do that, we have to hold Alt from the keyboard and drag and drop it to the layer like this. And if I click here, you can see the same effect here, but we don't want to apply it that much to our subject, so we will double click here and we will decrease this amount. We will keep it 19 pixels and click OK. So that's the before and after of the motion blur to our subject. So if I now hold Alt and click here, that's the before and after. So that's the way of applying motion blur to your images. Now we will see radial blur. We will apply spin radial blur to this object. Our object is already separated in a new layer, and we will convert it to smart object again. And after that, we will go to filter, blur, radial blur. And the blur method will be spin, and the quality will be the best, and we can increase the amount 17, and we will click OK. So now you can see the spin radial blur effect to this image, and you can also double click here and change the amount. You can also change the blur center. Like if I drag it to this point, then you will see this effect like this. Now it's considering this point as the center of this effect. Previously, the center of the effect was same as the image. Now we have changed the center. So it's looking like this. Let's undo the change. So after that, we will see zoom radial blur effect to this image. And we will again convert it to smart object. And then we will go to filter, blur, radial blur, and we will select zoom this time. And we will also drag this point to center, and we will increase the amount 23, and we will click OK. So this is the effect, the zoom radial blur effect, and you can again change this position to any direction that you want. If you drag it to this position, then you will see something that's heading towards this direction. So that's how you can apply motion blur and radial blur to your images. If you enjoyed this video, then you can give a thumbs up, share it, and subscribe to this channel. And in the next lesson, we will discuss about Gaussian blur and surface blur. So hope to see you in the next lesson. Thanks for watching.